Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Can we please have our feet to welcome the pastor? A few round of applause as he comes to you.
Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Were you blessed in the morning?
Truly blessed.
Do you really think that understanding the word of God and knowing more about God is a worthy adventure? You really think that is a worthy adventure? Knowing God, knowing and understanding God, it is. Christianity is not a religion, it's a lifestyle. In him was life. That life became the light of men. You see, if there was nothing like faith, people like us wouldn't have had this kind of family. People like us wouldn't have come to the level we are today. Because two ways to fund your destiny: wisdom and money. Faith is wisdom applied. And you see the result. When you see the result, you will know the truth. And the truth you know will let you free. Praise the Lord. You know, people use the word set you free. Now, why King James used make you free? He's trying to explain that there is no struggle. But other version uses set you free. And if you hear me very well, I say make you free. Because that word King James uses. Make you free. No struggle. Set you free sounds struggle. You need to cut it off. The knowledge you know, you don't put on, when you put it like there's no struggle. Like next week, like that. Shall know the truth, and the truth shall make you free. That's how King James says it. The other version says, set you free. Praise the Lord.
Amen.
Lord, thank you for this evening. In the morning, we did the first step, which is dwelling in Mount Zion. Discovering our Mount Zion. And this morning, this evening, I've come, oh God, to bring the exposition by the power of the Holy Ghost. The difference between a Zion, Mount Zion that has Jerusalem, and Mount Zion that doesn't have Jerusalem, which is a glorified clubhouse. Lord, I ask, if this is your wall, if this is your business, if these are your children, your generals, you have the power to take over the future. Let it reign, Lord. Let your power reign. Let the anointing reign. In Jesus' name. Amen. I'm also going to teach for another 30 minutes. And I want to make sense. Quickly go to with me to the book of Matthew, chapter 16, verse 18 and 19. Matthew.
Yes, sir.
No, chapter 16, yes, verse 18 and 19, sir.
Amen.
Amen.
And I say also unto thee,
I say unto you, Peter,
that thou art Peter.
Yes.
And upon this rock.
Upon this revelation,
I will build my church.
I will build my church.
In the gates of hell shall not.
You see what Jesus called revelation? He called it wrong. Revelation is elder sister to faith. Without revelation, there is no faith. You see, he that comes will first of all believe that he is. How will you see that he is? It's through revelation. Pathway to faith is divine revelation. Upon this rock, no one has revealed this to you. It's through revelation, Peter. And upon this, I build my church. And the gate of hell shall not prevail. And Jesus said, the foundation is me. There is no other foundation that can be there except the foundation that is there, which is Jesus Christ. How do you prophesy? Through revelation. The Bible says the spirit of prophecy is Jesus. The spirit of prophecy is Jesus. Am I making sense? Then I had ministers preach for over 6 years until I had people like Dr. Maestro. And they started speaking. They were preaching that to them. He said, wow. What kind of pastors are they? Where did they get their knowledge? And when I followed all the instructions my father gave to me, Abu Shabbat said, I was like, what you preach cannot affect you. Come and bless another person. Father, that's the key. That's the secret. Don't preach data. Don't be like a computer. Get data, deliver data. The Bible says, out of your belly shall flow rivers of you. Let it be something coming out of you. And I said, if I must preach this gospel, it must be out of my belly. I don't know what I'm saying. By revelation. Upon this I build my church, and the gates of hell shall not. Do you already understand what that means? Upon this I build my church, and the gates of hell shall not prevail. Church, look at it. You say, this is my church. If the devil want to call me, he cannot near it. If the church want to move anywhere, the devil can. That is why I keep on telling you. If your house is being used for home fellowship by a true church that has heavenly Jerusalem in there, if you don't buy the house, you just lost your opportunity. The woman that was saying that she's here to is biblical. If you don't buy the house, you miss your opportunity. Why? There are no more failures. The gate of hell shall not prevail. Do you know that the church is not these four walls? Do you know this might be the pastor? This might be the musical director? Do you know this might be the evangelism director? And you went to a girl and say, or a woman, or a husband, and say, I want to marry you, or you are my husband. Immediately you join with, if it's a lady, you join with her. You are, their family is a pillar. Church of God, you can't be employed anywhere.
there is no security for you. The church shall matter. The pillars of the church shall matter. And no gate of hell. Identify with the church and be a pillar in the church. What a mystery. What a sure way to be free from decay, shame, disgrace. But people have missed it. Now look at what has been happening to me in church accomplishment. I am among the pillars. And the devil knows he cannot catch me until I disengage myself from the church. I know my security. My security is to abide. It's to remain that pillar God has called me to be church accomplishment. And has church accomplishment moving forward. I'm among the pillars. Does that make sense? Are you grabbing it? The first step to hearing from Jehovah's mouth is what? Abiding, dwelling, being a pillar in Mount Zion. Which I taught in the morning. But this evening, the Bible says, God will say, I shall establish Jerusalem in Mount Zion. There are Mount Zion that doesn't have Jerusalem. Somebody quickly go to the book of Jeremiah. Let me see if I can bring out something there. Jeremiah 12:3. Yes.
For thou, O Lord, knowest me. Thou hast seen.
What are you reading?
Jeremiah 12. Chapter 12.
Read verse 1 and 2.
Jeremiah 12, verse 1. Righteous art thou, O Lord, when I plead with thee.
Yet to get you.
Thou hast planted them.
No. Try 13, verse 2.
Jeremiah 13, verse 2. So I got a great riddle according to the word of the Lord.
No. Okay, try 2:12.
Jeremiah 2:12. Now read. Be astonished, O ye heavens.
That's it.
For my people.
That's it.
Okay, Jeremiah 2:13.
Yes.
For my people have committed two evils.
My people have committed two evils. Now listen very well, because this is going to explain what I want to teach. Now listen. Yeah, this is good. Okay?
For my people have committed two evils.
Two evils, yeah.
They have forsaken the fountain of living waters and hewed them out cisterns.
Huge! They have built, they have carved out. Listen now. What is God saying? Listen very, very well. Get another chair for me. This is, yeah, get from there. Beautiful. This is God's system. This is the one permitted by God. You can pass it up. We continue, start again. My people have committed two evils.
For my people have committed two evils. They have forsaken me, the fountain of living waters.
They have said, being a member of the church is too hard. It's happening in Australia. Continue.
And hewed them out cisterns.
They have now built their own fountain of living water. Not only they have built it, they have made it very sophisticated. The one God built is at the center of the wilderness. Listen very well. God built water of living water. I said, this is where you get your water. But because it was situated in the wilderness, why must you go to? It's a long journey. Why must you go to wilderness? And you know there's no water in wilderness. That makes it very significant. Why must you go to wilderness? That is civilization today. He said, no. God said, it's only in the wilderness. That was the water that David drank. Living water. God said, that's the only living water. You must be one as the body of Christ. You must be on that, you must go that extreme. The people said, why must we go to the wilderness? And the Bible says, none of them were faithful that obeyed God in the wilderness. None of them. None was saved. But they say, no, civilization, we can. How did God build it? They took picture. They came and built it the way they want. It was even so sophisticated. That's it. Holy Spirit said, why are you going to go? God said, you shall come here. My people should not suffer. Serving God in a comfort zone. They have committed to sins. And they do not know there is no living water that can be as that one in the wilderness. Go there, get your water. Say, no, I can't serve under that person. I can't be in that church. I'm more civilized than that. Because if they have committed to sins, they have created for themselves Mazeon. And I can't establish my Jerusalem. Read it again, through so that we get it in one word.
I read Jeremiah 2:13. For my people have committed two evils. They have forsaken me, the fountain of living waters, and hewed them out cisterns, broken cisterns.
Broken cisterns!
That can hold no
water. It cannot even hold water! Jesus said, the water will give to you. When you drink, you will not thirst again. That's the water in the living water. You see, we can get this water from the bubble. We can boil, hold, and get it. My people has committed. It's not boasting. Go around. The person, Joseph, you are seeing here, I came with a different, I can, what is my system? Where is my father and mother? Nigeria. I can't disconnect with them. I can't disconnect with Abishom and the best. If I do it, I have rouge. If I break away, I have rouge. Another system that cannot hold back. God said, Indica, if you need to the workshop, I give you. It's your fountain of living water. Has it been easy for me to be getting the fountain of living water that I need from CGM? No! No! But immediately I leave. Church, can let me tell you something. You know? Where I am today, if I was getting my fountain of living water as easy from beneath, I wouldn't have been as blessed as I am blessed. I'm telling you the truth. And I would have been limited to whatever they give me. I would have been limited. But God has seen my faithfulness. And he said, I will be your son and your mom. No longer will you depend on the son. You depend on me now for your sunshine. And God loves you. Disconnect with the fountain of living water. My fountain of living water is Abishop and the resident. It's Church of God Bishop. I can't disconnect. It might be in the wilderness for me. It might be hard for me to assess it. It's not a problem. If I leave it, I lose my life. God said, when they find out that it's hard for them, it's a wilderness, they did what? They went and hewed. H-E-W-E-D. They carve that. Their own. And say, we will not go to his father. No one day has scorpion beating them. No one day has snake beating them. No one day you didn't lose anything. But they say we are no more good. And he said, that one you built can't hold water. Because it's not what you're doing, it's the word of God. And hold the walls. Continue.
14. Is Israel a servant? Is he a homeborn slave? Why is he spoiled?
Why is he spoiled? Why is he that? Church, did he get it now?
Yeah.
This is Mausoleum. I mean, this is Mausoleum where God has himself established Jerusalem.
Heavenly Jerusalem.
And this is what God said, I can't. He cannot hold water. So no need living water. Can't do a woman water. See, it's a broken foundation. Do you really think I'm making sense? Now, let me tell you something. If you're faithful with your tithe, listen very well, and you pay your tithe in this place, it flows because of his holy word. But if you're faithful with your tithe and you're paying it here, it cannot hold. Let me come again. If I'm a pastor that doesn't pay tithe and doesn't sow seed, if you pay your tithe under my ministry, you will not be blessed because I'm a dead seed. I'm not a moving. Does it mean that you're not obeying God, but it will affect your gift?